Well, hey there, it is Cecilia, and today is Q&A Thursday. You've got questions on your business, and I've got answers, hopefully so. I'm going to do my best to answer your questions while I'm allowing Facebook to put this out here in a few places. I'm going to get this shared in a few groups. For those who are watching me for the first time, my name is Cecilia Morris, and I go by the tagline. Yeah, you can hear me. I go by the tagline, I'm your engineer by education and your home business owner by desire, and I help network and affiliate marketers learn how to use social media and digital marketing strategies to build their brand and their business online. On Tuesdays and Wednesdays, I provide value, give you tools, tips, tactics, and strategies for building your business. And Thursday is what I'm going to start calling Q&A Thursday. My plan was, of course, to be here about 5 hours ago, but somehow, some way, life and business don't always intersect. But as promised, at least it's still Thursday. So let me get this shared in a couple of places, and then I'll go ahead and get started telling you, answering your questions. So there are some people that messaged me their questions because, of course, they couldn't be here at 4 o'clock. While Facebook is getting this set up for me, I am putting this in a couple of places where people might join in on the conversation. Once again, I help network and affiliate marketers. I've been in network marketing myself over 10 years. And 2 years ago is when I took my business online because I was failing miserably at traditional marketing methods. Stuff like the 3-foot rule, making a list of 100 people. I don't even know 100 people. And I would feel uncomfortable calling them out of the blue anyway. I bought lead lists, which took me absolutely nowhere. So I'm making these cold calls in the evenings and on the weekends. I got 1 of 3 responses. 1, the number was bad. 2, they didn't opt in for it. Or 3, they sounded like they were all gung-ho, and then they were full of shit. All right, so Q&A Thursday. This is all about online business building, online branding. All right, so I want to answer the question that I got by multiple people first, and then I'll work my way down my list. You know, I keep my handy dandy notebook with me, and this is where I take all my notes. So what do you do when people ask how much have you made, how many people are on your team, how well are you doing in your business? As I've said before in other videos, this is the most irritating question in the world to me. If our president, Donald Trump, does not have to produce his tax returns, why in the hell do you think I'm gonna tell you how much money I make? It's none of your business. However, the politically correct thing to say, when people ask you about money or how well you're doing in your business, you need to turn that question back around on them. How much money do you wanna make? And then they'll tell you, how much time can you put in to make that happen? And then they'll tell you, and you can shift the conversation from there, and you can put it back on them instead of taking the focus off of you. That is just a mere intimidation tactic because they want to know how well you're doing. You know, it's funny because in corporate America, nobody ever comes up to somebody's cube. Now, if you're an hourly worker, like on a production floor, you probably do have conversations about your money because you all start off at the same rate until it's raise time. And then everybody wants to know, well, how much of a raise did you get? How much of a raise did you get? But as professionals, nobody's ever going to come up to your cube and ask you how much money you make. So it's unprofessional to think you have to answer that question about your business. You are a business owner, an entrepreneur. You need to come from a place of posture and authority and be that authoritative person and turn the tables, put it back on them. How much do you want to make? How much time are you willing to put in? Of course, let them answer the first question before you go to the second. When they talk about how much time they're willing to put in, then you can have a conversation on what they need to do with that time in order to reach their financial goals, not yours. And then if they continue to press you on the money issue, you can also tell them, well, I've been at this for X number of months, years, however long you've been into it, and you're just now getting started. So what I make is no indication of what you make. And it also, once again, put it back on them. It also is determined by how much time you are willing to put into yourself to make the money that you desire. Okay. The next question that I got asked, what do you say when people talk about your business? You know, a lot of people don't understand this thing that we're in. You know, the question you hear all the time, is this a pyramid scheme? Now, nobody wants to hear that their job is a pyramid. There's the CEO, the CFO, the CIO. other people, and then you fall somewhere on the pyramid. Now, you may be one of the lucky people that are high enough on the pyramid that you are higher than, I shouldn't say higher, that's not the right thing, but you know what I'm saying? You may be somebody that's in a decent position on the pyramid, but you're still in the pyramid. Nobody wants to hear that about their job, but they always want to talk about network marketing as being a pyramid scheme. Well, it's only a pyramid scheme if the company that you're with does not have something that you can offer to the public. You know, the scheme that Bernie Madoff was in was where he was robbing, I wouldn't say robbing the rich because they were all rich, but he was taking people's investment money and then using their money to pay other people who had already invested. So he was promising, hypothetically, a 10% return on your investment. So if that is the case, he's got to get other investors to put in money so that way he can pay you your 10%. That's not what network marketing is. Network marketing offers a product, service, or opportunity that you can provide to the general public. It's only a scheme if you don't have anything to offer. And the way you can deflect that question is by saying, well, what makes you think that? And then they'll have to answer what makes them think what you're sharing with them is a pyramid scheme. So I want you to think about any question that makes you uncomfortable or makes you kind of break out in a little bit of a sweat. Always think of a way to turn that question back around to your prospect. Anytime they want to know about your money, is this a pyramid scheme? How much are you? How big is your team? Always turn it back around on them. Well, how much do you want to make? How big of a team do you want to have? How much work are you willing to put in? Well, why would you think this is a pyramid? So you can always turn those questions around. All righty. So another question that I got this week was regarding email marketing, knowing what to say. So this question came after I did my video on, I think it was Tuesday, where I talked about the 6 steps in storytelling. But basically, refer back to the Tuesday video if you have a question on how to do your email marketing, because your story is a story. Those 6 steps that I went over on Tuesday, you can use them whether you are writing in an email or you're speaking to someone through a video. But remember, the 6 steps are: give it a place where something happened, share your pain, let people know what your epiphany was, your aha moment, explain what happened to you because you had the aha moment, give the benefit to the prospect, and then have the call to action. Those that can be via video, as I did in my Tuesday video, or you can use that same outline when you're doing an email. So that is how you build your emails. And you always want to tell a story. And you know, I think I said this on Tuesday as well. People always share their success, like, look at this check I got, or look at what's going on. But what people never talk about is the struggle, the pain that they went through. Hi, Thomas, thank you for joining in. People never share the pain that they went through in order to get to the success that they now have. Like I said, in 2015, for 8 months, I failed miserably and I lost lots of money using traditional network marketing methods. I was like, you know what? Either I'm going to find a better way or I'm getting out. I'm out, right? Now, what if I'd have just said in 2015, I'm just done with this. I'm going to work a job until I retire. That's all I can do. Just suck it up, buttercup. This network marketing thing, you just can't get it anymore. Well, if I'd have thrown in the towel in 2015, then I wouldn't be able to share all this knowledge that I've learned with you in 2018. So make sure you share your story, because people like to hear the underdog story about the struggle to success. People want to know what it takes to get to where you are. I remember when I was in corporate America and the team members were on break and I was walking through the break room. I can't remember what I was doing, but anyway, one of the team members, the factory work, distribution center workers, asked me, how did I get my job? And that like really cracked me up on the inside, because I'm thinking, girl, you poor little girl. You just don't know, do you? So I asked her, I said, do you have your high school diploma? And she said, no. I said, do you have your GED? And she said, no. Now I could have been like, what do you mean? What did it take me to get my job? Or girl, what? No. But I was like, okay, you don't have your high school diploma, you don't have your GED. How do you expect to get a job better than working on a factory floor if you're not even educating yourself? Well, the same thing applies to your business. Not only do you have to educate yourself about the company that you are associated and involved with, but you need to educate yourself and get the tools on how to market yourself effectively online. This thing that I do may look easy, but it is 2 years worth of blood, sweat, and tears. All right. So remember that. Share your story. Not only does sharing your story help you build the know, like, and trust factor, but people know that you're vulnerable, and they also know that you're relatable. And the story can be either video, email, however you want to share it. It can be a post on Facebook, however you want to share it. Just share your story. All right. So the next question that I got, and I'm going to end with this one because I didn't get a whole right, Thomas. We all have a story. Exactly. So quit sharing the sunshine and give them a little bit of the rain. So this is the last question that I'm going to share tonight because I got a lot of these questions based upon a training that I'm going to do on Monday the 13th at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Facebook ads. What to do for profitable Facebook ads? There are so many different variables that go into what makes an ad profitable that I'm doing a boot camp on it Monday at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. I'm going to go through the whole process, the Facebook ads, the different types of ads, what they're used for. I'm going to talk about pixels. I'm going to talk about posts and how you can boost the post and actually turn that into an ad. So if you want that information, I'm going to put the link in the comments right now, because I'm only going to do this live in my Facebook group. So if you want to watch it, you got to be on the live in order to get the information. So I'm posting that link right there. So just click and ask for permission to join that group. And then you can be on the Facebook Live where you can find out what to do for profitable Facebook ads. And you know what? I said that's the last one, but I'm actually going to give you one more. Because this goes to a coaching call, a client call, excuse me, a potential client call that I had today. And her problem was building her team. She does okay with the people that she reaches out to herself, but the whole reason why a lot of you got into this affiliate or network, network marketing business is because you want to build a team. You want that residual income from not just your work, but the work of other people that you have brought onto your team. So she wanted help with team building. And the only thing that I can tell you, because this is what works for me, sorry, I'm a little juicy today, is you need to empathize. When you're talking with someone, especially prospect or a potential client, listen to their story, ask questions to understand their story, and let them know that you've been there before, that you empathize. Basically, you need to empathize with them, and you need to be relatable, which goes back to the storytelling. You have to be relatable, and people need to understand that as much as you may seem like a rock star, and in our heads, we are all rock stars. And if you don't think yourself as a rock star, I think you are a rock star. Work on that mindset. However, it didn't just happen overnight. So as long as you can do those two things, empathize and be relatable, you will have success building your team. All right, so those were the top four questions that I got for Thursday Q&A. Sorry it's a little late, but Thomas, I'm glad you were able to jump on and be here with me. Thank you for joining. For those who are gonna watch the replay, give me a hashtag replay. My goal is to do Thursday's Q&A at 4 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. I'll try to do better next week. Remember, I'm going to start focusing on my YouTube channel. So if you want to get more instructional and tutorial type videos, make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel. Cancel that. I'm going to put the link in the comments right now. So that way, like I said, you can get more instructional and tutorial type videos there on YouTube. I am going to be on Facebook Tuesdays and Wednesdays, providing you value and information that you can use in your network or affiliate marketing business. And every Friday, and this will be every Friday, you will get a new video from me that is informational, tutorial based, and will give you some step-by-step DIY type of stuff that you can do for building your brand and your network or affiliate marketing business online. All right, so here is my YouTube link. I'm going to put this in here now so that way you have it. My name is Cecilia Morris. I am your engineer by education, your home business owner by desire. And thank you for joining in with me for Q&A Thursday.